Hello, this is Robert from Microchip Technology. Today, I will be covering the new multi-voltage I/O peripheral, or MVIO for short, currently available in AVRDB. This video will cover what MVIO is, where it is used, and the benefits of MVIO. One of the biggest challenges in designing a product, system, or even just a prototype is matching all the voltage levels in the system. Conceptually, it sounds simple enough. However, in practice, you may run into a wall where there isn't an alternative to having a sensor or other device run at a different voltage level. In most microcontrollers, the biggest problem with interfacing to a higher voltage device are the electrostatic discharge, or ESD, diodes. These diodes are designed to conduct voltages above the operating voltage and below ground to the power supplies to protect the device from static electricity. However, in this case, the voltage applied to the input may cause the diodes to instead pull current from the digital input and sink it into the power supply. To show this concept, consider this configuration where the microcontroller runs at 3.3 volts and the sensor outputs 5 volt levels. The diode connected to the positive power supply is forward biased and begins to conduct. If left unchecked, the diode may heat up and damage, or even destroy part of the microcontroller. There may be other effects on the I/O circuits as well. The discrete solution to this problem is to use a level shifter, a special digital circuit that can safely convert a digital signal from one logic level to another. However, this adds to bill of materials, or BOM, and takes up extra space on the PCB. The MVIO peripheral is a much better solution to this problem. MVIO allows for a specific I/O port of the microcontroller to run at a different VDD than the core. For instance, to interface a 3.3 volt microcontroller with 5 volt logic, simply enable and power the MVIO section with 5 volts. The rest of the microcontroller can run at 3.3 volts or another valid level. This can be also used in reverse with the microcontroller at 5 volts and the logic at some arbitrary level. The MVIO port on AVRDB functions as low as 1.62 volts and as high as 5.5 volts. The MVIO pins do not sacrifice digital functionality for this feature. Pins are still fully compatible with the digital peripherals on the device, including hardware-based SPI, I2C, UART, and PWM, in addition to the regular I/O operations. Currently, analog pins are not available on MVIO ports. MVIO can be enabled or disabled by setting a fuse on the device. Let's go a little bit deeper into the specifics of MVIO on AVRDB. The MVIO peripheral is designed with power sequencing protections and monitoring. If either the microcontroller's main supply fails or the MVIO supply fails, then the pins are tri-stated. If the MVIO loses power and regains it later, the pins will reload their configurations. If the microcontroller's main supply loses power, then the device will reset and the I/O pins will have to be reconfigured in software. There are multiple monitors for the MVIO power supply. One monitor available is the ADC, which can internally sample the voltage through a built-in times 10 divider. For continuous status monitoring, the MVIO power supply also has an interrupt that is triggered whenever the power supply drops or rises above the minimum operating voltage for MVIO. Finally, there is an event signal that indicates if the MVIO power supply is above the minimum level. The MVIO peripheral offers unparalleled flexibility in design and prototyping. This peripheral, while simple to use, has advanced features that enable effortless monitoring of the MVIO power supply. In the next video, I will show you a way to use the operational amplifiers on AVRDB to power the MVIO with only a single jumper wire. For more information about AVRDB and MVIO, please see the links in the video description. If you like this video and would like to see more, please like and subscribe.